everybody, it's Angel from the Natrona County Library, and I wanted to bring you guys a story from the great outdoors. It's a beautiful day today, so I wanted to tell a fun adventure story out here. I hope you can hear me because the creek is going by behind me and it's making that lovely sound, but it might be too loud. I hope it's not. Our story today is called Ready for Anything by Keiko Haza. Duck arrived at Raccoon's house on a bright and sunny day. "Hey, Raccoon," said Duck, "are you ready for our picnic?"
"I've changed my mind," said Raccoon. "I don't want to go."
"Why not?" asked Duck.
"Well, I've been thinking," said Raccoon. "What if we're attacked by killer bees?"
"No," said Duck.
"Yeah," said Raccoon. "And what if they chase us, you know, and we fall into the river?"
"Oh, no," cried Duck.
"Oh, yeah," said Raccoon.
"And what if we swim for our lives, but a terrible storm strikes?" "Oh, no, oh, no," yelled Duck.
"Oh, yeah, oh, yeah,"
a raccoon went on.
"And what if we look for shelter in a cave, but there's already someone in there? Someone scary."
"Like who?" asked Duck.
"A dragon!" shouted Raccoon.
"Ah!"
they both screamed.
And they hid under a blanket.
"It could happen, you know," Raccoon warned. "Picnics are dangerous."
"You're right," Duck said. But Duck thought for a while. "But Raccoon, what if some lovely butterflies pass us by instead of bees?"
"Whoa, that would be nice," said Raccoon.
"Yes," said Duck. "And what if we follow the butterflies to the river and jump in for a cool splash?"
"Oh, that would be even nicer," said Raccoon.
"Yes, much nicer," Duck said. "And what if the weather is beautiful with just a gentle breeze blowing? We could fly a kite."
"Oh, gee, that sounds like fun," Raccoon admitted.
"Lots of fun," Duck said. "And then we could find a cave to explore."
"Oh, don't go in," Raccoon shouted. "There's a fire-breathing dragon in there, remember?"
"Maybe," said Duck. "But what if it's just a cute little baby dragon that wants to play with us?"
"You think?" said Raccoon.
"Sure," said Duck. "And what if we have the best picnic ever? Roasting marshmallows."
"Wow," said Raccoon. "Your what-ifs are wonderful, Duck."
"What are we waiting for?" Raccoon cried. "Let's go on a picnic." "That's the spirit, Raccoon," Duck cheered.
"Just give me a few minutes to get ready," said Raccoon.
So Duck waited and waited and waited some more. Until finally, Raccoon announced, "Okay, Duck, I'm ready to go." "Oh, Raccoon," Duck fell over laughing. "You worry too much. But I guess you're ready for anything, huh?" At last, the two friends went on their picnic. "Thanks, Duck," said Raccoon. "This is so much more fun than hiding under a blanket." "No problem," said Duck. "Trust me, nothing can go wrong with a little picnic." But then they got there, and Duck gasped. "Oh no," Duck moaned. "I forgot the picnic basket." Duck wanted to cry, but Raccoon stayed calm. "No problem," Raccoon declared, opening his backpack. "Like you said, I'm ready for anything."
anything.
He brought some food.
Wow. Oh my goodness, that's a fun story. We can be scared of lots of things, but we can also be safe and have a lot of fun too in the great outdoors. So I hope you guys are having a good day. We will see you hopefully soon at the library. Bye for now.